film to be any different. Are you voices ready? Excellent.
You know what we've got, Nathan?
I thought the players were coming out, but I have been mistaken.
Star player here, goalkeeper.
I thought we were about to do a rendition of Aladdin for a second, but I don't think that's what we're doing.
There's our...
Is this your mascot? That is absolutely fantastic. Well, I was being honest about my life, but this is amazing. Look at that.
You know what we've got, Nathan? Our first competitor for the crossbar challenge at half time, I think.
I'm sorry, I got so mind blown by the mask over to my left that I got.
This is the under-14 girls' final. In the white shirts are Blenheim High School, based in Epsom, just less than 3 miles from the racecourse that will stage the derby in 10 days' time. And their opponents have travelled a little bit further. Durham Johnston School from the centre of Durham in the red shirts. The referee for this one is Stephen Saunders. The Durham girls actually travelled down from the northeast, 6 hours on a minibus as far as Aylesbury yesterday, spent the night a little more locally, but they have had a 1 hour trip to Reading this morning for this game. This is the Durham team, and a fascinating story about number 10, Ellie Reed, who returned from a family holiday in Florida just yesterday morning. And it's currently 6:30 a.m. in Orlando, so goodness knows where Ellie's head will be, but Durham are very happy to have her back. She scored 7 goals en route and scored in the semi-final, so a very valuable member of their team, even a little jet-lagged. Blenheim's leading goal scorer is number 10, Bronte Walder. She scored twice in the last 6 minutes of a semi-final that they were losing 2-0 at the time, forced it to extra time, and Blenheim High School came through by 4-3. So the two most important goals of the 13 that Bronte Walder has scored en route to the final were in the closing moments of the semi. Just a 12 woman squad for Blenheim High School, just the one substitute available for them. Remember, repeatable substitutes are allowed. This is 35 minutes each way. They play with the size 4 ball, and inside that trophy is the Durham Johnston mascot, 10-year-old Samuel White, who is the son of the manager Andrea White, one of the teachers at the school, and he broke his arm playing football for his school, a goalkeeper just on Saturday, but he wasn't about to let a minor injury like that stop him being here as the mascot today. John Scales is alongside me, and a wonderful atmosphere. Interesting actually that quite a few of the games en route to the final played on a much smaller pitch than this in girls football, but they play on the full size pitch for this one, 35 minutes each way.
Yeah, well, fantastic conditions, and what an opportunity to play in such a wonderful stadium as here, the Majewski Stadium in Reading. The sun's out, the pitch will be dry now. They watered it early this morning, but I think by now 11:30 it'll be pretty much bone dry. It just held up over the last couple of days. We've obviously had 10 matches on Monday and Tuesday, one this morning. And the girls will be itching to get out there and get this game underway.
Blenheim High School to kick off in the white shirts, unbeaten all season. They won the Surrey Cup last week. They have a semi-final in another cup competition to come. Durham Johnston in the red suffered their first defeat of the season in a county cup final last weekend in extra time. So two in-form teams.
Oh, we'll see how that's affected Durham's confidence.
Rhea Hatton making a nervous start. Right back for Durham Johnston, Sophie Miller does have a long throw, and bursting onto the ball here is Emily Salmon with an early chance. Just leave it off the ball, some strong defending, but Emily Salmon has gone on and scored in 32 seconds. And Durham Johnston lead.
Wow,
she did so well to resist the challenge.
Well, you've got to say, the ball over the top, they just went to sleep, didn't they, Blenheim? Caught out in these early, early stages of the game. The throw-in, over the head, over another one, and she's away. Good first touch, great second touch. You just think, is she going to wilt under the challenge? She doesn't. She holds her form. And in the end, it's a magnificent opener. And that'll really settle their nerves, Durham, after that defeat last week.
And they've got another opportunity straight away here. Just got away from Emily Salmon that time. Well, she scored in every round en route to the final. 20 goals in the run, including two in the semi-final. Add to that now one in the opening 30 seconds or so of the final. What an achievement for the Pacey Durham Academy forward, number 9, Emily Salmon.
Well, it's your dream start, isn't it?
Here comes that long throw again. And it's almost forced a corner kick. And goal for Blenheim High School is Lara Sparrow.
Yeah, Hannah Pinchbeck just getting a touch on that long throw.
This is Amy Bouye. Won back by Amelie Derry. And there's a flag up against Bronte Walder. It's just beyond the last defender.
Well, Bronte Walder, there's going to be expectations on her shoulders here this morning. She's trying to live on the shoulder of the defender, the last defender there. Just drifted into the offside position.
Pinchbeck winning the ball in midfield for Derry. A little bit of space on this near side for Bex Teal. Getting onto a favourite right foot, skidding the fullback. Teal with a shot, and she just sliced it. She did have players in support, both Mayors Beth and Walter were in there, but I think Teal deserved the opportunity to shoot herself.
Well, I think she did here. You'll see. I think it's Sophie Miller, number 5 for Durham, just still deep. She doesn't do really well. Rebecca Teal to go past her, pull it across the face of the goal, and just done enough to pull in that far corner or somebody to get on the end of it.
So opportunities for both sides in these opening moments, and a suggestion that this could be a finely balanced final.
Well, you can just see the depth. They're just out of sync at the back four, not in that perfect line, Durham. That's giving Blenheim just those opportunities to find a little bit of space and width in the channels between the centre-half and the full-backs.
Derry likes a shot from range, and she's struck a post, and it's come back out. There's an opportunity for Mayors Beth, which she's just dragged wide. Well, Amelie Derry, number 6, does have a reputation for shooting from long range, and she caught that beautifully.
Well, I didn't really expect too much to happen here, did we? Great touch outside of the foot, and then she hits it from there. It's a lovely strike. Keeper nowhere to be seen. Flags up for offside, but well, they're trying to force this issue to get the equaliser, aren't they? Really on the front foot this last few minutes, pushing Blenheim Durham back.
And Teal is giving Miller all kinds of problems on this near side. Misplaced return pass from Mayors Beth. Durham clear their lines, and they've already shown their ability on the counter-attack. Good defending there by Rhea Hattam.
Good battle down below us.
Pinchbeck winning the throw.
Yeah, they've just got that fear, I suppose, the back four for Blenheim. They're aware of the pace that's in possession in this Durham side.
Here's Pinchbeck again, looking for Derry. Clearance is by Tabby Noble. Opportunity again for Teal to feed the ball into the box, and it almost comes for Bouye. Support from Derry, and we've seen how she can shoot, and she's done it again, and this time she's found the back of the net. Amelie Derry equalises. We've had 5 minutes. It's Blenheim High School 1, Durham Johnston 1. High quality strike from range by Amelie Derry.
What a stunning strike this is. You just think they're in the box. She's going to have the composure just to set it back, Amelie Bouye. Oh, absolutely no chance for Erin Jack in the goal. It's a wonderful strike, superb finish. We're back on level terms, inside 5 minutes, and we've got a real cracking game on our hands here.
It's Derry's 13th goal of the run. There is a bit of a joke inside the camp that she needs 25 shots to score once. Well, she's had two today, and she has scored once. She got a hat-trick in the Surrey Cup final just last week, so she's in form. Goalkeeper committed, and here's another chance, and another goal for Salmon. Terrible mix-up in the Blenheim defence. Absolute presence of a goal. And no sooner had Blenheim got themselves back on terms, and with 6 minutes gone, they're behind again.
Well, that's remarkable, isn't it? Totally innocuous sort of ball forward into that area. You think it's going to be dealt with by probably Casey Bray. She's got to hook it, clear it. Look at the frustration by the goalkeeper. She's got to be careful she doesn't get injured. Lara Sparrow.
Sparrow is just receiving a little bit of treatment at the moment.
Yeah, she's got to calm down, hasn't she? I think the frustration about that situation, I think, has just sort of overwhelmed her a little bit. She hit the post in disgust with what happened. And I think the coach is as much about just checking on her foot with hitting the post as much calming her down.
Interesting, the coach, Stuart Millard, is a goalkeeper himself. He's played for Epsom and Newell at a decent level in non-league football, so he knows all about the trials and tribulations being the last line of defence, and he's just trying to console his goalkeeper, Lara Sparrow.
Well, I like that moment, you know, that you can actually, at this level, even in a cup final, you know, the referees had the sensitivity to just allow the coach to come on and have a little word with her, just settle things down. Big occasion, and that's handled really well all round. What a mix-up.
Derry forward, cut out though by Noble. Here's Pinchbeck. Back out to Amy Bouye. Certainly got a couple of very useful wide players, Blenheim, Bouye, number 8 on that far side, Bexteel on the near side. Derry charging forward to the edge of the box again, but the clearance is good, and here's Ellie Reid. It's going to run for Walder. And that was a little too ambitious.
Well, Ellie Reid's got a really important role to play, hasn't she? Number 10. Just sitting alongside Emily Salmon in that sort of number 10 role up front alongside her. The two of them are a real potent threat, and they're on the attack again, just given away by Rebecca Copeman. She's going to get a second chance here.
Oh, the clearance is under hit. They are having some problems at the back. Got that one all wrong. Number 7, Casey Bray, got away with that error, and the chance for Bouye to come forward. And they really have got the beating of the fullbacks, Bouye and Teal. Another bold run by Bouye. Just want to throw in.
That's lovely work over on that far right-hand side.
I did check a pronunciation before the game because the teachers had told me it's Bouye, but she tells me Bouye. And I've now told the teachers, and she will get her name correctly pronounced in class from now onwards.
Oh, I love it. Oh, I'm very grateful you found that out.
Derry with a shot, hooked away.
I hate getting their pronunciations wrong.
By Maguire, chance for Salmon to break again. And they really are a threat on the counter-attack, particularly number 9, Emily Salmon, who has those two goals already. One back by Copeman. Real zest in attack from both teams. Ball had just gone out of play on that far side.
Casey Bray on just a couple of occasions, just looking to get that tackle in, just not able to break up play from Blenheim's point of view. But I think that's more to do with the pace and speed of Durham on the break, and Emily Salmon in particular. It was a lovely shot there, wasn't it, when she broke away and there were 5 white shirts descending on her. She got past one, and then the 5 of them sort of surrounded her, and her touch wasn't able to put it around the fullback and go on and maybe bear down on Lara Sparrow's goal.
Got a funny feeling this is not going to finish 2-1. Opportunity for Mayers Beth. He's trying to link up with Bouye. Durham managed to clear their lines this time. Here's Salmon. Derry managed to hold her up at least in midfield. Emma Sludden on the ball. Challenge was a firm one, wasn't it, from Bex Teal. Away by Sophie Miller. And as far as Derry, he's seeing a lot of the ball. Good challenge by Copeman.
Yeah. Only Derry unfairly on Sophie Miller. Referee pulls it back.
The girls need a bit of a breather. Three goals in the opening 6 minutes here. Here's Teal.
Oh, lovely ball.
That's a fantastic pass through, and Becky Mayers-Beth is in here. That was a really good chance. She struck it firmly, but she was just under a little bit of pressure. I think it was Maisie Maguire who got across to make it as difficult for her as she could.
This is a wonderful ball, isn't it, from Rebecca Teal. Finds the space, has the touch. Just pulls it, pushes it wide, just cuts across the ball. Got to hit that far corner. Go back across the goalkeeper.
Pinch back quickly on the goal kick, but it's fallen initially for Durham, then Derry wins it back. Pinchbeck is probably the hardest working of the Blenheim High players. Salmon tracking her back and winning the ball back, but then presenting it to Derry, who'll go from range again. And it's very important that Erin Jackson, the Durham Johnston goal, watch that carefully.
Yeah. Mayers Beth just putting pressure on the goalkeeper, but comfortably collected.
Warder. Again, the threat down the flanks, this time from the right, from Bouye. Good ball in, a chance for Mayers Beth, and that's a decent save by Jax. Reacted well. Still Bouye. Rather desperate defending, but effective. It's come out for Pinchbeck. She didn't quite get hold of that under pressure.
Well, they're getting so much joy down that right-hand side, aren't they, with Bouye. She's going to get the ball again. No, she's not keeping it tight in the middle. Riddles away from the challenge.
Taking it on herself, shooting again, and this time just over the crossbar. Well, she's had four shots now. Amelie Derry, we're only 13 minutes into the game, but she has scored once.
No wonder they say that she needs 25 shots. She probably has 25 shots a game.
She's on Millwall's books. She's a real all-rounder. She's played football, basketball, netball and hockey for Surrey. First change is going to see Jenny Horridge come on for Durham Johnston in midfield. Pinchbeck trying to thread it through. Ken out though by Maisie Maguire. Reed on towards Salmon. Here's this counter-attacking threat again from Durham Johnston. Strong and pacey Emily Salmon. Two goals to her name already. Just taking on a little bit too much this time because Bouye is there. Now Derry. Looking for Bouye again, but good tackling back by Salmon, who is now on the ball, trying to thread it through to Reed. One back by Derry. Cut out in no-nonsense fashion by Miller. And it's an awkward 1-2 for the right-back Ocean Garman to deal with.
Well, they're under pressure on every occasion, aren't they, that the ball goes up to the front. There's Casey Bray who dealt with the first one. Here she is again. She's got to deal with this. Go back to the keeper or sweep it away. She hasn't done either, really convincingly.
Very edgy at the back there, aren't they? This is Copeman. Defender recovered pretty well.
Yeah, there's just such nervousness. I'm not surprised, you know, conceding a goal in 1 minute, another one inside 6 minutes, two goals. Doesn't fill you with the greatest of confidence in these sort of occasions.
Surely Miller can't throw it into the penalty area from there. She nearly did. There's Walder. That's good work by the substitute, Horridge. On again, though, by Bex Teal. The referee getting in the way. Well, we complain when they're too far behind the game. Here's Derry. I think Walder would have been offside anyway.
Yeah,
the flag has gone up. Always a lot of sympathy for a referee when he gets hit like this. See all the concern from all the other players. Not. Derry. He's managed to thread it through, and that's a really good ball by Meyersbeth into the path of Bex Teal with a chance here. Oh, second time they've hit the woodwork. And you know, Blenheim High are losing here, but they probably had more of the game so far, John.
Well, I think they have, and I think you just mentioned it. This is going to stay at this score line for too much longer, and certainly not for the entire duration of the game. Just that back line of Durham really does concern me. They don't seem to be working perfectly in unison with each other.
Salmon on the break again, just being held off by Rhea Hatton, but there's not much you can do when Salmon starts to move. It's a very ambitious shot from range. Looking for a hat-trick though already.
Yeah, but I think that's wonderful. Here's the ball that's played out wide. Cuts back inside. Shot hits the bar. But I think the keeper was beaten, possibly. Well, they're looking to get back on level terms. Blenheim High School. Outstanding performance this school has had. And from September this year, they're going to have a girls-only sixth-form football academy that's in association with Chelsea Foundation. And it's going to allow those girls between the ages of 16 and 18, they're really going to have a unique opportunity to learn and develop their football.
It's another long throw, and it's caused another problem here for the Blenheim defence, and the referee's got a call to make, and he's given a penalty. They just haven't dealt with that long throw at any stage of this game, and it was a pretty clear shove in the back.
Yeah, it's another throw in they haven't dealt with, isn't it? Straight through. I think it's Ocean Garman coming in. Bundles are over. Pretty easy decision for the referee to make.
Emily Salmon, who won the penalty, has now got a chance to complete a hat-trick. Very confidently done. 19 minutes play, and Durham Johnston lead by 3-1. And Salmon has a hat-trick.
Oh, remarkable. Hat-trick inside 19 minutes, and Emily Salmon.
I beg your pardon, I don't think she took the penalty. I think the penalty may have been taken actually by Holly Middleton. 8 and 9 are quite similar on numbers. I think that's Holly Middleton, isn't it? In the red boots, yeah.
Yes,
Holly Middleton,
right.
It is, yeah.
The 3 goals inside 19 minutes, and they've really emphatically stamped their mark on this game. Durham.
I've got a feeling Salmon will get a hat trick, by the way. Just delayed the inevitable. Here she is on the ball, trying to find Reed. Again, unable to clear their lines, and Copeman plays it in, and Lara Sparrow just needs to settle those defenders down in front of her.
But they just haven't got to grips with things at all, have they? The long throw in, the ball over the top, that throw in again that time.
Here's Bex Teal, though. Got plenty of support. Maybe carried it a little bit too far. Meyersbeth was waiting. It's come out as far as Bouye, and Derry going glory again, just a little bit too far out even for her, surely. Frustration for Blenheim High, they've had so much of the game and they find themselves 3-1 down.
Well, this is a remarkable thing, isn't it? I mean, there's a long way to go in this game, but, and this is the most important thing, that the message comes from, I think, the sidelines. You know, they're vastly experienced, they've had a phenomenal season. That message has just got to be, don't panic, keep playing the way you're playing, because they haven't done that much wrong, certainly going forward. Defensively, yes, questions can be asked, but yeah, full of endeavour going forwards.
The Blenheim girls were actually wearing Chelsea training kit when I was watching them warm up in the Reading Dome before the game. A year to the day since this team represented Chelsea in a Premier League schools tournament at Stamford Bridge and won it. It's a good corner too in towards Derry, and she almost managed to force the ball forward. Goal kick's been given.
Well, she wants to add to that equaliser that she got at to make it 1-1. Get her team back in this game. Coach looks anxiously on from the sidelines.
It is worth recording that they're almost out in the semi-final. They were two down at half-time. As I say, they scored twice in the last 6 minutes there to force extra time and win it 4-3, Blenheim High. So they're used to coming from behind. But another problem for them at the other end. Casey Bray just trying to respond. Garman chasing back. And maybe they need more of that kind of clearance, really. Just get it away.
Yeah, it's Casey Bray on a couple of occasions, just not knowing what to do when that ball sort of just bounces around. As soon as it's bounced, it's very difficult and awkward to deal with when you've got Emily Salmon breathing down your neck.
There was a little nudge there, in fairness, so yeah. They have a free kick.
Teal, just a lovely little step over. Doesn't take the ball with her. She's going to win it back, though, is she?
She doesn't give it up either, does she? Once again, almost winning it, and in the end, forcing a rather anxious clearance.
Yeah, it's good to see tenacious in the tackle. Not wanting to give away possession.
There's the Miller throw again towards Salmon. Down goes Middleton. And free kick has been given. Derry penalised.
Yeah, right under the nose of the referee. Again, you feel the ball's going to be swept into this box. Put this Blenheim defence under even more pressure. Lara Sparrow maybe needs to come a couple of more yards off the line.
Miller's free kick has been cleared. Walter couldn't quite direct it as she wished for Teal.
They're just nervous. They don't want to go too tight to her. A sort of stick or twist, isn't it? Do I go tight, make it difficult for her? Does that, with her ability to sort of roll a defender, they want to stand off because they're scared of her pace. She's asking a lot of questions of this big back line of Blenheim.
Middleton with a throw. Helped on by Reid, but cleared. Just being a little bit more cautious in their defending now, Blenheim High. Getting the ball away. Middleton again. Hit by Salmon, might come on that far side. It's cleared away, Sludden it was, who was waiting for the chance. Derry just slipped. And didn't stop her keeping hold of the ball, and Teal's onside here. And Durham have been exposed, and she's got support from Mesbeth. Teal's going to go it alone.
Oh.
Just over the crossbar. I think Becky Mesbeth maybe just strayed offside at the crucial time, and Teal looked up and thought twice about providing the pass.
Well, Amelie Derry, I just saw there, she'd hung back. She'd started the move right from the halfway line, fed that ball into Teal. And then the ball went over the bar. She slumped forward with her head in her hands. Desperation that the fear is it's not going to be their day. It's going to be substitution.
Libby Morris is coming on in place of Jenny Horridge. They are going to keep rotating players in midfield, part of the Durham-Johnston strategy today. And it has been a very high-paced game so far. Blenheim High only have the one substitute available.
Well, it's midday here in Reading, at this wonderful stadium. Sun bearing down on these players out on this pitch.
Copeman. Salmon wasn't quite expecting that, but she fancies her chances of running Rhea Hatton. Going to win another corner.
Yeah, Hatton does well, but you can just see again now Emily Salmon has that maturity to just understand how to ride the challenges, lean into the defender.
Danny started playing football at 11. She's really taken to the game. She looks a natural. Number 9, Emily Salmon.
Well, she's got a great striker's instinct, hasn't she? And just knows where the weaknesses are, works it out immediately the game starts, knows her strengths. That's a good challenge.
Slodden barged off the ball by Leah Sheeran. Sheeran, I should say. Leah's down the number 5 for Blenheim High. Joe played for AFC Wimbledon. Forward, scored a lot of goals in the Isthmian League. He was at Chelsea as a youngster with John Terry. And his daughter Leah now plays for the AFC Wimbledon Juniors. Number 5 for Blenheim High, Leah Sheeran. Not a bad club to play for, Wimbledon, John. Didn't do you any harm.
Had their moments, didn't they? Was it nice to do that's offside? Nice to do at the House of Lords last Thursday. Relief for everybody associated with the club that they avoided relegation, and another team we won't mention, unfortunately, going the other way.
Neil Ardley's an old boy of Blenheim, of the school that we're going to see in the next match, Carshalton Boyd Sports College.
Yeah, ex-colleague of mine, and yeah, what a wonderful job he's done there now. I think it's 5.5 years he's been in the job. He's done really well on such a small budget.
Under 14 girls final. Durham Johnston in the red, leading by 3-1. 3 goals poached almost on the counter-attack. This is Ellie Reid. Salmon benefiting from another error at the back, this time by Sheeran. Salmon goes on. Good recovery by Sheeran. Really important that she did that. She was beaten initially. Slodden back to Salmon. And Sheeran's done really well again. That's much better.
Yeah, they'll give them a little bit of confidence at the back, but they will be short-lived with the qualities that they really have shown Durham in that attacking third. Persisting with this sort of long throw-in, putting them under pressure at every moment they have.
Middleton's arms are a bit weary now, I think. Here's Derry. Early forward towards Teal. She has had some opportunities already, Bex Teal, and she's got in again here. Denied by the goalkeeper. Very brave keeping by Erin Jacks. Really good goalkeeping too.
Wow, it's a wonderful save. Absolutely, you felt Teal was favourite to score. I thought she'd just waited maybe a second too long. She should have taken that rebound a moment sooner. Just allowed Erin Jacks to have that opportunity to save it. The ball through again, looking for Teal. They're getting some joy down this left-hand side. And it's Amelie Derry again having success with that ball in between the fullback. She cuts across. Yeah. Wonderful touch. Good save. Stands up big and then, oh, just that moment. Good goalkeeping.
Another chance for Walder. Helped on by Bouye. This wouldn't quite fall for Walder. Bouye sticking at it. Comes out as far as Derry. Cleared though by Coatman. Slodden with the challenge this time for Durham Johnston. Here they come on the break again. They are quite something, aren't they? Good run by Salmon. Reid is up with her. It's Reid shooting this time. It's just why did it? Yeah, it was a good save, I think, by Lara Sparrow.
Well, I think this could well be in contention for possibly saving the tournament. Let's maybe make the shortlist. She does well. I mean, you've got to give credit to Sheeran. She sticks at it. And then that's fantastic. Lets it run across her body. And look at that for a save. Absolutely brilliant from Lara Sparrow.
She's had a tough first half, but that was outstanding goalkeeping by Lara Sparrow. brought away by Bouye.
She's done so well this first half, hasn't she, Emily Salmon? You just see the, I love the way that the physical part of the game these girls are relishing. Just know how to sort of ride the challenge. Defenders put under pressure at every moment because she's chasing everything down. I think it's not allowing them to have a moment's peace.
The mascot bringing Durham Johnston plenty of good luck at the moment.
You can go back in there again.
Pretty hot in there, young Samuel. Here comes the latest long throw from Sophie Miller.
She's going to get another opportunity. Just a little bit of a lull. Crowd have gone quiet as we head towards half-time.
Brand new boots today, Sophie. We were discussing it before, and I'm not sure that's a great idea in a final, but first time she's worn them. On by Salmon, might just fall for it. It's a corner kick to Durham Johnston.
Just come off Rhea Hatton.
Those white boots will never be that clean ever again. Miller will take the corner in her new boots. Oh, it's been flicked on. There's a chance there, and it's just clipped the crossbar, has it?
Yeah, keeper was beaten. But it just clipped the top of the bar.
It was Ellie Reid who had the chance.
Yep. Just not really dealt with it, the near post. Ball gets swept in. A couple of opportunities maybe to get there. Keeper beaten, and it just flicked the top of the bar. She's put a defender, Casey Bray, under a little bit of pressure, deals with it well. They've got possession now. They've got to make things count from these areas a little bit more. It's given away too cheaply. They're going to get a throw in down in this final third. And as we approach half time, you really feel like Blenheim need to get maybe a second goal to go into that half time team talking. Their tail's a little bit higher and
pinch back
up a bit.
The shot, charged down though, very bravely by Miller. Here's Derry. Bray. Out to Garman. Here comes the threat from Bouye again.
She had so much joy early on down that right-hand side. Haven't seen too much of her. She's got another chance.
Mesbeth got it back to her. Bouye's cross. Might come for Walder, might come for Teal. They just defended a little better, Durham Johnston, than the opponents. The threat's been there from Blenheim, but since that long-range effort from Derry, Durham Johnston have done just enough defensively.
Yeah, I think it was substitute Libby Morris just doing really a decent enough job on Bex Teal coming in at the far post. There she is, she's beaten her, gone round the outside. Actually, she gets down to the byline. Lovely step over.
Teal of Chelsea, just against the shins of Nadia Suno. A chance for another break led by Salmon once more. She's so good on the ball. Carries the ball quicker than the defenders can chase her. It'll come out for Sludden. And that's
ambitious.
Yeah, that's a little beyond her, I think, yeah. Particularly at this stage of the half, last minute. Start to feel it now.
Yeah, just going back to Emily Salmon, just down right in front of us. What a wonderful turn. Let the ball come onto her, outside of the foot, roll the defender. Rhea Hatterman, and off she was away, and had the presence of mind to have a lovely ball into Ellie Reid. It comes to nothing.
Sheeran carrying the fight from deep. Really bold run by the centre-back, fantastic run. Blenheim needs some inspiration now, and Leah Sheeran trying to provide it now. Can they come up with something in these closing moments of a first half that they've certainly had plenty of possession and plenty of threat, in which they trail by 3-1. Here's Derry. That's a good challenge. Just playing one added minute. Salmon challenged by Derry, strongly but fairly. Derry again, now one last chance perhaps for an attack set up by Bouye. Hooked rather wearily into the centre. Garman trying to keep the attack alive. Pinchbeck's there, but is beaten to the ball. Forced away by Miller. Hit by Derry. Chance for Teal! And they've got one back on the stroke of half-time. It fell rather fortuitously for Bex Teal, but she kept ahead and slotted what could prove to be a vital goal for Blenheim High School.
Well, what a time to score, and it's Emily Derry with the miss hit. And she's found on a number of occasions Bex Teal in that channel. She didn't mean it on that occasion, and what a time to score the equaliser. That will really change the whole atmosphere within that dressing room. At 3-2, it's a very different game as it was 3-1. Durham totally in the ascendancy for much of the game numerically, but I think that's a fair reflection of this half, blending with their tails up.
The English Schools FA PlayStation Schools Cup Festival coming live to you from the Medeski Stadium in Reading. We have got a cracking under 14 girls final at the break. It's Blenheim High School 2, Durham Johnston School 3.
Well, there can be some strong team talks in the changing rooms at half time here. But look at the grin on Durham's trophy. He's delighted. So then, we have got five competitors for our half-time entertainment, which is the Crossbar Challenge. And here to show you what needs to be done is Matt on the ball. So this is a simple challenge. As we're going to see from Matt here, the ball is on the penalty spot. All you've got to do is clip that crossbar.
Not give it any chance, and here we go again. And he's got a bit of pace on it, fumbled. Chance for Mark Robinson, and what a save that is. What a recovery save. And that, well, he may have fumbled the first attempt, but he made up for it with the second save there.
Yeah, he's redeemed himself there, isn't he? Jeremy Mensah. Fumble, gets to the, you know, bravery. You've got to give him that.
That's super.
To get back to the ball, and then a fantastic follow-up save.
A bit disappointed there, that could be the end of his final. Mark Robinson, looks like they're changing the formation. Oh, what a save that is! And that's a whip shot there from Aweru from distance, and the keeper managed to get across quickly. I don't know if we see it. This is a great angle to view
I think this is save of the tournament so far. I think this is a brilliant save. Where here, he's close, he's in, he's got his space. Look at that.
What a save.
I mean, a brilliant save. Very, very good performance. Man of the match.
And Sengul shot his save. Keeper saved again. Superb goalkeeping from our reserve goalkeeper here. Dom De Castro Buns, and then Sengul showing he's got a left foot as well as a right. Comes in. He's taking on players for fun. Bang. Great save to start with, and then there's the follow-up.
Yeah, excellent, wasn't it? To pick a player of the match, I mean...
Here's McLaughlin, looking through. Oh, she's gone round another one. What a move this is! Incredible! Saved by the keeper! Chance! Oh, and Framer's put it over. Oh, unbelievable skills.
I mean, it is unbelievable.
Well, I've got to see this again. Look at this play from McLaughlin. She's going round players as if they're static. What a turn inside, and the shot on goal. Great save from the
what
keeper.
What a save.
And Framer, coming in with a swinging foot, ball's gone wide.
This must be
a goal. Oh, what a save, what a save. And the referee's gonna give a free kick surely for that, and he has done. But what a save it was. And the referee, yes, the players are celebrating, the referee, Let's have a look at a replay. Yeah, the referee has definitely given a free kick. There's no doubt about it.
It's got to be a goal. Unless it's a brilliant save.
Yeah, they win against Kennett School 9-0. We'll just stop a second here because Whitgift pushing forward. There's a shot from distance, and is that a save? It is. That's a cracking save, and he's pleased about that. Owen Hay. Let's watch this one again.
Sure, he's got a fingertips to see it here. Again, they back off, don't get tight enough to him. That's a great save.
Brooke Myers under 14, Elite Schools Cup. Whitgift again up against KPS School. There's a chance, here's a chance. Oh, what a save! And what a run and a double save! Well, Alfie Lamb, Owen Haig in the goal. For Northampton has just kept his team in this. What a run this is.
Yeah, it opens up for him. Shape of time.
Here's Raymond. Unleashes a shot. Chance on the edge of the box. Great save from the keeper. Blake's on the edge. Hits the post. Great save from Ben McDonald again. Keeps his team in this match.
Great goalkeeping, wasn't it? Burst through. You think the shot comes in. Defenders get in the way. Good save. You think he's parried it into the path of Blake.
Oh, there's a nice ball through.
It's run nicely.
Here's Thompson. Thompson releases one. Oh, what a save that is. That was a really high-class save from a goalkeeper. And this is why perhaps Dennis Whittington is the captain of this team, because he's just pulled out a top-class save here. That was going towards the top corner.
It's my shot at the moment. Save of the tournament. Look at this. That is going in the top corner. Great save. I mean, some absolutely wonderful saves there. I mean, what a list. 9 outstanding saves. There's Mensah and Haig getting in there twice, showing their skills. What a superb festival we've had these 2.5 days so far. A couple more games to come this afternoon, but really is a wonderful setting. Fantastic weather. And those players there just showing their worth in every single one of those games. Some outstanding saves. I'm sure a lot of people will have their favourites. I don't think anybody envies me having to make a decision on picking the winner of that bunch.
Alex, what's the answer? How many PlayStations is too many? Never too many PlayStations. Depends how many friends you've got. Well, I think Nathan, we might break the silence here by bringing out the T-shirt cannon, the rocket launching T-shirt cannons. Okay, how much PSI have we got in this? Well, this one's heavy. Wrapper. I'm going to charge it up. We've got about 190 PSI in this one. Can you load me up, young lady? Are you going for the double? Okay. Of course, the T-shirt cannon only gets aimed at the noisiest side, so I'll let you decide who actually wants free T-shirts. You can have it. Okay. Oh, the mum just popped up her lung screaming. Okay, I've got two in here and I've got 190 PSI. By my physicistical calculations, I think I'm going to get one to the man in pink and one to the lady at the back. Okay, you ready for this? 3, 2, 1. Oh, I thought I'm actually going to give them both to the man in pink. There we go. That was exactly what I was planning. I was just falling in. Right, a quick couple over to this side. On the Durham team, who would like some free PlayStation T-shirts? I'm going in, hands alive. Oh, he's taken out the dugout. Oh, which way should I go? Which way? Okay, let's do this. Just, if I've let it quiet. Just a bit quiet.
Okay, I'm going to go just you, sir. Yeah, just you. You've got to shout stop. Okay, now you got to say stop. Say stop. Okay. There we go. That was a good game, wasn't it? I had my eyes closed the whole time. Could have just... If you'd gone, all right, stop, and stop. All right, though. Well, please welcome your teams back onto the field. Durham and Blenheim.
The teams are coming back out for the second half of the under 14 girls final. It has been an enthralling contest so far. Blenheim High School in the white shirts, 2. Durham Johnston School in the red shirts, 3. We had 3 goals in the opening 6 minutes. A goal in just over 30 seconds to help us on its way. And it certainly lit the blue touch paper of this game because it has been relentless since then. Substitution for Durham Johnston. We'll see number 12, Holly Cook, coming back out onto the field. Or is it Holly Cook? Yeah, coming back out for Ellie Reid, whose head must be spinning a little bit. She's the young lady who flew back from a family holiday in Florida yesterday morning. So she's going to get a break. And Holly Cook, who did actually start the match, has come back on. Goal in 32 seconds of the first half. What are we going to get at the start of this second half? Durham Johnston, who been in front since that opening minute, counter-attacked superbly and probably just defended a little bit better than their opponents. Maybe that's been the difference so far, John.
Yeah, I think it has been. Yeah, I've had a nervousness looking at that Blenheim back line every time that the ball's gone forward, both self-inflicted and also the way in which Emily Salmon has led the line for Durham. Just looking at Durham, conceded some goals on the route to the final 18, I think, in those 8 matches.
Derry with the free kick. It's come out as far as Mayersbeth. Here's Pinchbeck. Derry. Just couldn't quite thread it through, and it's cleared by Nadia Suno. And here's that counter-attacking threat once more, with Salmon trying to link up with Cook. And Salmon really does have a steely strength. She wins the ball so often in those kind of situations when she looks second favourite. And it was bold defending in the end by Ocean Garman.
She's got a sick at her task today, hasn't she?
Jenkins trying to force it forward, and Garman concedes the corner.
Oh, she's got a work cut out, hasn't she? Salmon loves running on this channel, putting her under pressure.
Yeah, and the number 2 is actually qualified to play for the under-13s, Ocean Garman, so she's playing a year up.
She's having a little rest on the post. Not surprised. Whew.
Corner kick to Durham Johnston. Defended well by Derry. Up to Walder. It's a good ball, that, from Walder. Bouye. Never quite had that under control. Pinchbeck, though. Derry. Here's Garman. Derry. On again to Amy Bouye.
Oh, just loose on that touch, wasn't it? Just looks maybe a little bit tired. Bouye, that's such a great start to the game. She needs to get back into that form, get her energy levels up and work well with Derry. Yeah, it's just Blenheim only conceded 8, so 10 goals less, and they've looked a bit vulnerable in this match so far.
Unbeaten all season, don't forget, the team in white, but trailing 3-2 here. Here's Bex Teal, scorer of the crucial goal on the stroke of half-time. Really good on the ball, again, stretching the defence and forcing the challenge from Suno and forcing the corner.
Oh, she's full of endeavour every time she gets on the ball. She's got one thing on her mind, hasn't she? Drive towards the goal.
Teal with the corner. She can stay out there for another one. Number 10, Bronte Warder, is probably the tallest player in the box there. If they can get the ball in the air, Derry's quite tall too. And yet another corner.
Peppering the near post.
I think it's probably as far as you can reach, if the truth's told. Well. Again, this is a full-size pitch. It's a big ask for under 14 girls.
She's not the most powerful, is she? Let's see. There you go. Legs have given up on that third attempt. Somebody maybe should have gone over there and taken over the duties.
Corner. Maybe a short corner work it play. Yeah.
Well, that's a strength. Short corner would have been the answer, I think. She's got to chase back.
They've got away with that a little bit, Durham Johnston. Ball's broken quite kindly. Holly Cook's waiting in the centre, but it was well defended by Sheeran. Away in the end by Casey Bray.
Well, I feared for Sheeran for a moment there. She was the wrong side. Fortunately, was able to avert the danger.
Here's Salmon again, just helps it goalwards, and seized upon by Lara Sparrow, who made that outstanding save in the first half.
Yeah, she did, and she had to be assured of her handling there.
Forward by Suno. Salmon in pursuit.
There's
again,
no offside.
She's managed to slip away from Bray. It's a dangerous ball. Cook can't quite catch up with it. And Lara Sparrow is there.
Well, there's no offside in that because Ocean Garman was still coming out, the right back here. They're just a little bit disjointed again in their shape.
Here's Pinchbeck though. Searching ball forward. Teal getting on the dangerous side once more. It's got the ball stuck between her feet.
Well, that's what I was saying about this pitch. You know, they watered it this morning first thing and it made a real difference to that first game with the ball zipping about here. It's just holding up that little bit more.
Stuart Millard, the teacher in charge, big Arsenal fan.
It's going to go for a corner, is it?
He's been taking the girls from McDonald's after their victories on the way to the final. He's really going to push the boat out if they can come from behind and win this one. They're going to go to Nando's.
Oh, that'll be
obviously a health kick.
Worthy of that treat, yeah. It's, no comment on their diets, but we'll have those for a treat every now and again, aren't we?
I think they've run the calories off today. Pinchbeck with a corner.
Well, this is the fifth corner in the last few minutes. And as you pointed out, you know, maybe if you're thinking about a little short one, maybe somebody from the back, 3v1, they can come onto the edge of the box. Just change it up a little bit. It's a bit predictable. They're all making the same runs again, but it's never going to go beyond that near post. And there's
Hannah Pinchbeck takes.
Look.
Well, it's been stolen back and rather sliced shot. Maybe had a moment there to take a touch before she had a pop at goal.
Yeah, there was a moment, but I don't think it was as close as the ooze from the crowd below us suggested. Or
gentleman in the foreground is an interesting character, the Durham Johnston coach, Mally Harvey. His daughter played for the school. She left 3 years ago. Mally didn't. He's a really enthusiast, loved working with the girls, and has stayed on as the main coach. Here's Pinchbeck. Got a bit of defending to do his girls at the moment. Hooked away by Suno.
It's funny to say, I wish my school, for my two girls, they're 9-11, I wish they played football. I think it's a great game for girls. It's just got a bit of everything. It's competitive. You need the fitness, you need the work, the team, ethic. There's this change.
Yeah, Blenheim High only have the one substitute. Rhea Hatton giving way to Freya Chabot, number three. Shabba's going to play it left back. Headed by Derry. That's a really good ball and an opportunity for Bouye to get in. She does have support. She'll go there alone. Oh, stopped by the goalkeeper's foot. Big chance that for Amy Bouye, but Erin Jacks managed to react. Probably should have scored, really.
Well, she's got to score. Look at this for a pass. Pass of the match. Into the space. Bouye, lovely touch here. Across the defender. Takes the defender out completely.
Got another opportunity. And this time Walder's denied by the goalkeeper.
There she is, Bronte Walder. What a chance that was. The keeper keeps the minute again. Erin Jacks. Showing her worth. Stood tall to that initial chance.
She thinks she's a better outfield player, apparently, Erin. But Mally's not having that.
Somebody's got to do the job.
Derry. Away by Miller. That's for fashion. Erin Jacks is certainly seeing a lot of the ball at the moment.
Yeah, she is. And I've got to say, Emily Derry, wonderful job. Just in that deep-lying midfield position. There she is. Touch. Lovely touch. Yeah, just pass the ball. Pop it off. Try and feed out wide here.
Here they come again with Amy Bouye. Sludden managed to hold her up that time.
Well done.
Bouye so good on the ball. Constantly testing the Durham Johnston back line. Garman with the throw. It's reached Derry. Hacked out of harm's way by Copeman. Salmon on the ball. Maybe tiring a little bit. Here's Teal. Fed into Walder. Mesbeth had so much space in the centre for a moment there. Still Teal. Just beyond Mesbeth this time. Still an opportunity this time for Pinchbeck. And now for Bouye. Stayed on her feet. Oh, it's a great ball to Walder and a really good goal. 3-3. Hooked in at the far post by Bronte Walder. Blenheim High's leading goal scorer, but all the credit really to the skill on that audacious cross from Amy Bouye.
Well, what wonderful composure from Amy Bouye. Held off the challenge. Would have been really tempted to have taken the shot. Maybe thinking about a few moments earlier where she was through and could have scored. And, well, Bronte Walder, top scorer, I think, for this team, Blenheim. And they're back on level terms.
I think she can smell that Nando's. Here's Mesbeth. Halted in midfield by Maisie Maguire. Pinchbeck. Oh, it's such a good pass. And Walder's onside and through again. Fired goalwards. Oh, just clips the woodwork. Is that four times we've seen the frame of the goal hit during this game on almost 2 in 2 minutes for Bronte Walder. And Stuart Millard knows his team are right in this.
Oh, I was looking for the flag. Flag didn't come up. The appeals went. Didn't lift it. And then, oh, what a relief for the keeper just to see that go past the post.
I think that goal on the stroke of half-time by Blenheim High could prove to be the crucial moment in this game. Teal getting the goal, but Salmon is always a threat. Galloping forward again. Seen off by Sheeran this time.
Excellent defending. It's much better.
Derry. Dispossessed. Pinchbeck is there. She does so much work on behalf of Emily Derry.
Yeah, she's done really well, hasn't she? I think she's been a real rock, Pinchbeck.
Ocean Garman. Nearly said floating forward, but
I love that name.
She has won a throw-in.
Mission.
Derry. Pinch back. Pressure growing from Blenheim. Derry going it alone.
Well done.
We know she can shoot. Just take on a bit too much Suno stud ground. Well, the ball has been won back instantly by Blenheim High. Durham are treading water at the moment. Garman. Sludden got a foot in. Throw in.
It's okay. Another substitution.
Durham Johnston just need a bit of a pep up, and Ellie Reid is coming back out onto the field, replacing Holly Cook.
Probably a little bit of jet lag. Is there? Does she have a rest? Just come to terms with where she is.
It really is anxious back there now for Durham Johnston. Holly Jenkins just forcing the ball away. She's one of the Sunderland fans in a team of mainly Newcastle fans. Kept alive by Garman. Good work by Walden. Here's Derry. She's just trying to float that towards the far corner, I think.
Yeah, Bronte Walder's covered some ground as well. You're sort of drawn to Emily Derry, but you cannot overstate the importance of Bronte Walder, Becky Mayersbeth, Rebecca Teal, and of course, Bouye playing this wide right position. Really of a sort of a front three, just over the head of Bex Teal. Putting them under pressure again. She's got to deal with this.
Forced away by Sophie Miller, and she's going to goal kick for her troubles.
Yeah, they haven't really been troubled, the back four, have they? For the last sort of 15 minutes or so, Blenheim.
No, it's all been Blenheim since the break. Durham Johnston actually encountered a Wembley Cup finalist en route to Reading. 76-year-old George Courtney, MBE, refereed a couple of their games. He's always been a teacher by profession in County Durham. FA Cup final referee, 1980, went to a couple of World Cups. Did you ever encounter George?
Yeah, absolutely. How can you forget George?
Still a great supporter of youth football in the northeast of England.
What a huge figure in football Courtney was. And
sounds like he sent you off to me.
Do you know what? I think he quite sort of relished coming down to Plough Lane. Sure, I remember him refereeing a game at there, and he actually, I think, enjoyed the occasion, the challenge that it posed him.
Not many did. Still Blenheim High keep coming. Still Durham Johnston hang in. It's all they can do at the moment. They were 3-1 up, it's 3-3 now. Derry. She's just about up to her 25-shot quota now, but she carries a real threat. I think she's entitled to have a go. She's a lovely striker of the ball.
Yeah, she is. Oh, it's one-way traffic, isn't it, at the moment? You just think, I wonder what that bench of Durham Johnston school are thinking down there. How are they going to get the impetus of this game?
We're going to have a water break, and I think that's sensible from the referee.
Well, I do. There was a game yesterday that you just felt the players came over to the sidelines, were actually looking for water. The schools hadn't been prepared and didn't have much. I think there was about one bottle between the whole group of them, but much better to see them with plenty of hydration coming on board. We've had 52 minutes, so still some considerable time to go in this game.
Yeah, great credit to Stephen Saunders, who's refereed this game very sympathetically throughout, and mentioned for his able assistants, Matt Loughlin and Andrew Hunt. Matt Leary is fourth official for this game. He's going to take charge of the next match. And we can't have football of this kind. We simply cannot have an English Schools FA PlayStation Schools Cup Festival without the officials. Eight finals at Stoke earlier in the month. Five finals here on Monday, five more yesterday, five more today. It's a wonderful event. Over 200,000 young people have been involved in these competitions from their outset. Day three of three here in Reading.
Staggering numbers, isn't it? It really has just grown and grown and grown in stature. And PlayStation Schools Cup Festival here at Reading. Wonderful occasion.
And just in case you're wondering, if it's still 3-3, in 18 minutes' time, we would go straight to a penalty shootout.
Yeah, we haven't had one over the last couple of days. I doubt we're heading for one either. Just got that feeling that there's going to be plenty of drama left in this game.
Most of it at this end of the field, because Blenheim High are well on top now. Bouye coming again. Very hard ball there. A little bit of respite for Durham Johnston. They can barely get out of their own half of the field. Blenheim High with a bit of defending to do. Casey Bray and Leah Sheeran have been watching with the rest of you for the last 15 minutes or so. Well,
now they're going to be called upon.
Jenkins with the throw.
They've got to deal with things.
Turn away by Bray. Reed dispossessed. Pinchbeck's there again. Real unsung hero for Blenheim High, although she's lost the ball to Reed this time. Jenkins trying to squeeze it forward. No chances being taken by Tabby Noble. Here is Noble again, caught in possession this time by Bouye. She's had a tough afternoon so far, Noble against the excellent Bouye. This is Derry. Fired in towards Walder. First touch was excellent. And so was the defending. Hooked out of harm's way.
That was crucial because Walder just looked for a moment where she might just get round the defender there. Would have been away.
Good work by Copeman. He can return to the game after being substituted. So it's important that if you come off for a break, that stay loose, keep stretching. Maybe needed. I'm sure Blenheim High are going to have to call on everybody in a 12-woman squad.
It's a big challenge, isn't it, for the players out there, only having 12 in the squad. I think that makes a difference, having three on the bench.
There is the substitute, Shambo, getting it away. And Salmon, who's been out of the game unusually for since the break, is getting a rare touch.
Well, they're just totally unable to get the ball down and have any sort of possession, are they? And so full credit to Blenheim High School for the way that they've approached the second half. I think you're absolutely right. That goal on the stroke of half time from Rebecca Teal has been really, really crucial. Instrumental in the change of fortunes here.
Good work by Sheeran there, because we know how dangerous Salmon is, but there's no way that Leah Sheeran was going to let her turn or get on the ball that time. It's a Blenheim throw. Here's Salmon. Again, that acceleration and strength, and she's done so well. She's had to go that alone. There wasn't a red shirt anywhere near her.
I just felt she needed to take that on again. Again, she just sort of rises the challenge of the defender. She almost sort of just leans in, doesn't she? Sort of to know where they are. She's going to pick the ball up again here.
Soon has found Reed, but so too has Pinchbeck. I think it has been a big ask this fair. Ellie Reid flying back from a different time zone. Here she is on the ball again. This hasn't quite been at her sharpest. I've heard good things about her. She's made a real impact on the way to the final. Bouye. Walder's got to stay on side. Bouye tried to play it in, forced away by Sophie Miller.
Oh, Bouye. Oh, you can just tell the legs are tired out there, and no wonder. Almost bang on the hour mark. We saw it at the other end, Emily Salmon, when she went down the other end. Thought she should have taken it on one or two more.
Yeah, you can
touches.
Tell from Mally Harvey and Andrea White's body language that they know that they've got to make every opportunity count in the Blenheim half of the field, because they're not going to get too many. They didn't make the most of that. Here's Derry. That's a really, really good challenge. Forced away by Holly Middleton. And now that chance of the counter-attack. And here's Salmon again, stretching her legs, going for goals. Didn't quite have enough energy to truly test Lara Sparrow. But she remains a threat, Emily Salmon.
Well, you're absolutely right. I mean, she's still got some freshness in her legs because she's had a quiet second half. The ball hasn't really been down that end. So she maybe hasn't expended as much energy as a lot of the other players on this pitch.
Miller didn't quite clear the ball as she wished to there. Teal into Pinchbeck. Trying to thread it through. Walters offside. Flags up. Mayor's best going to be called back.
Yeah. The official very quick with the flag. Walder just drifting into that left channel. Offside. Hello there. They're enjoying the day, aren't they? What a wonderful occasion. What a superb achievement to get to this final for both these two teams. And how finely poised is this? 3-3, 10 minutes to go.
Yeah, I think it might be a little bit longer than that because of the water break, but we'll see. Derry just run off the ball, almost getting it back, and does get it back. Derry to Garman. Here goes Amy Bouye again.
Well, it's always been the cover. She's always got past one, but there's always somebody else. They've really got the numbers back well, Durham, but you just feel that they're being pegged back on the back foot. They're going to be able to find a breakthrough.
Yeah, you get the feeling that Durham will probably take penalties right now. Copeman. Sheeran couldn't quite deal with that. Salmon almost got to it. Here's Bouye. Dispossessed by Sludden. Trying to get it forward early towards Salmon. Garman runs it out of play. Jenkins with the throw. Turned away by Sheeran. Here's Derry. Early forward, and then the flags up against Teal.
Oh, unlucky, because what an opportunity. Walder on the ball there. Teal right on the shoulder of the fullback.
It's a clever run because she cut inside the fullback and almost invited that through pass.
Another fantastic pass, wasn't it? And I've got to see that again. I think that was very tight. Suspected she was going to be given the benefit of the doubt. The official gave the referee no chance not to give it.
We are into the last 10 minutes now, and you sense the next goal would be a winning goal. Here's Mayor's Beth. It's going to be a corner for Blenheim High. He's got to find somebody who can reach. He's still got the energy to get it in there.
Pinchbeck comes over. Still not going to see a short one.
Taken by Pinchbeck. It's a really good one, and Derry forces it forward. Not quite sure with which part of her body, but it fell quite kindly for Erin Jacks to make the save.
She doesn't want to look at the replay of that too many times. Emily Derry possibly should have scored.
Sparrow coming off limits and doing the sensible thing.
Well, we'll have another look at this. It's sort of, she's not quite sure what part of the body to sort of make contact, let alone whether to have a shot, a header.
Terrific corner.
It's a great corner. It's the best of the day.
Oh, might have been her arm in truth. Throw in by Jenkins, turned away by Sheeran. Bouye. Towards Derry. Steps away from Suno. Oh, now is Teal offside.
No. Yeah. She tried to stand her ground. She knew she was offside. She just paused for a moment. No, he's got that one spot on, I think. From my perspective, yeah, she knew she'd gone too early.
Referee just telling her to calm down a bit, and we could do without the boos from the other supporters. There's a very clear code of conduct which is sent to players and parents before these finals, and abuse of the officials is an absolute no-no. Rightly so.
There's no need for her to go too early then, was there? And
here's Salmon. John Scales was never guilty of dissent ever in his entire professional career. That he can recall, but he did head the ball a lot.
I left that to others.
Plenty in your team. I couldn't get a word in edgeways. Easy enough for Lara Sparrow, who's recovered really well after a difficult starting goal, and some real authority back there, and one outstanding save and in the first half. And Blenheim High won't forget that if they're fortunate enough to win this final. The goalkeepers may have a big part to play in a shootout yet.
Yes, just exactly where my mind went. And wouldn't it be ironic to think that Lara Sparrow might end up having the biggest smile on her face of all after those pictures of her almost in tears at the beginning of the game when the coach was on there, and the disappointment of that sort of needless in many ways concession of the goal. Seems so long ago, doesn't it? Those three goals in that opening 6 minutes was just an astounding start to this game. We've had three more since.
Still in the balance. Garman with the throw, forced away by Miller. Garman once more. Reid gets it clear. Now it's Salmon finding Reid, but Garman's got it back. Miller clear. Interesting to see how much time there is to add on. We're certainly ticking towards the last 5 minutes. We did have a water break in this second half, which the referee would have taken account of. Bouye. Derry run off the ball. Good work again by Salmon. Derry, early ball forward. Well met, though, by Sophie Miller. Kept her concentration, kept her eyes on the ball. Pinchbeck has asked a lot of Mayor's Beth here. That's not going to go out of play, though. Maisie Maguire has to deal with this, and instead it's come for Walder. Bouye. Mayor's Beth was offside, and she was going to make an attempt to play the ball, so free kick will be given to Durham Johnston.
Well, I think, you know, it is that time. It's so finely poised, and it's almost sort of regrettable when you've got to make a choice of a player of the match at this stage of the game. I'm going to give it to that girl there, Amelie Derry. She's had an outstanding game in the middle. She's been supported brilliantly, I think, by the players around her. Bronte Walder, Bouye, I think, has done ever so well. Pinchbeck has been magnificent. But she's the pick of the bunch for me.
Garman under pressure from Reid. That's really good defending at this late stage of the game. Temptation must just have been to knock it out of play. Instead, she's found Derry, who's found Pinchbeck. Early forward towards Walder. Couldn't control it, but it ran away and almost into the path of Teal. Pinchbeck again. Space now for Bouye. Durham looking a little bedraggled back there. That's a good recovery there, nonetheless, by Maguire.
Well, Teal on that left-hand side and Bouye on this right-hand side. They've done excellent work. I mean, the effort that they put in, the metres and yards covered on this huge pitch. It's not often they play on a pitch this size, and they've been tested in these conditions. Not only is it hot, but the pitch is dry, and that really does take a toll on your legs. So full credit to both these sets of players.
Now, is this the moment? Time ticking away. And a free kick for Blenheim High School. Have asked most of the questions since equalising early in the second half. 3-1 down after 19 minutes. Pinchbeck with a corner in towards Derry! There was your player of the match gaping chance to win the match.
I can't believe it. There you go. Lovely ball. Drilled in. It wasn't whipped in, was it? It was just sort of a drill in there. And there it is. It's a free header. Oh, Emily. What a moment. What a chance. Is there going to be another? Is that going to see us go to penalties? I think the coaches will be down there anxiously thinking, what's my lineup for penalties? Is there still an opportunity for
two added minutes coming?
One of these two sides to snatch it in the dying seconds.
Garman forward. Good strong defending by Sophie Miller. Might just run for Salmon. Sheeran sees to it that it doesn't. He's giving it back to Sludden, though.
They have grown in stature at the back.
Garman under pressure.
They got themselves sorted out, didn't they? And huge credit to the Blenheim back line. Much better. Sheeran had an excellent game. They had some nervous moments early on. Casey Bray, but enormous credit to all the players out there to stay in the game, get themselves back level. In with an opportunity still to lift the trophy.
Pinchbeck, Bouye, throw into Blenheim.
Just over a minute to play.
Pinchbeck in towards Derry. Strong play by Emily Derry in towards Walder. It's come for Teal. She's got a chance to win it, and she has won it. Rebecca Teal steers home the winning goal in the final minute, and Blenheim High School 3-1 down during the first half. Lead for the first time in the game, and what a time to take the lead with Bex Teal's second goal for them.
Well, if you thought the first one was important just before half time, what about this one? Surely the winner. She's had a couple of opportunities. I don't think there's any time for Durham Johnston to get back in this game. And, well, incredible scenes here at the end of the game. Seconds left, and have they got any time to put Lara Sparrow under any sort of pressure?
Still an opportunity that Salmon couldn't quite make the most of this time. Unbeaten all season long. They've been staring defeat in the face for much of this final. But Blenheim High School have come from behind to win the under 14 girls tournament with virtually the last kick of the game. John, you've seen all the finals here this week. Have you seen a more exciting match?
Well, I've never seen drama quite like it. I've seen 11 games. And this is just quite remarkable scenes. Who would have thought when they were 3-1 down, heading towards half-time with a crisis about to unfold in that dressing room. They looked down and beaten. And then just that glimmer of hope with Bexteel getting that second goal. Tails were up at half time. The conversation would have been very different. They got it back level, and well, you've got to feel absolutely desperately sorry now for Durham Johnston. Fine first half. They really faded and found it very difficult going, being pegged back and pegged back. And well, Blenheim High School, what a season they've had. What a moment for that girl, Bexteel, and all the players coming over to their supporters to celebrate a fine, fine victory.
Two down at half-time in the semi-final. They scored twice in the last 6 minutes to get out of jail there. 3-1 down here in the final itself. A goal on the stroke of half-time and a goal as late in the second half has won the under-14 girls tournament for Blenheim High School of Epsom.
Well, certainly something in the personality of this side, isn't there? We talk about the semi-final.
School motto? Believe and achieve.
Well, they have got a phenomenal work ethic. Very fortunate girls to be now being linked with Chelsea Football Club and the work they've done there. You've got to give Tony Boddell, the head teacher, huge credit for what he's done with this school. We'll look back at the highlights of this game and we'll see this remarkable story unfold. Emily Salmon away, and what a start they had. This is inside 30 seconds. You think the challenge had come in. I think it was Leah Shearing. But that long throwing caught them all off guard in the early stages of this game. There she goes. She's had a superb season. Just thought the opportunity was missed. It falls nicely and invitingly for her. She puts it away. 1-0 up. And then you see Blenheim desperate to get back on level terms. And look at this. Swept in beautifully. What a stunning strike this is. Superb goal from my player of the match. She was influential in everything she did within this game. Amelie Derry. Beautiful strike. Wonderful goal. They were back on level terms, but for literally seconds. Because within 6 minutes, this happens. Complete confusion in the back line of Blenheim. They're all at sea, and huge credit has to go to Emily Salmon for the panic that she put into this defence at every opportunity she had. And Ellie Reid. And there it was. 2-1. That lead very quickly re-established. Remarkable moments throughout that game, and at 2-1, just inside 19 minutes, this ball is swept home to make it 3-1. Holly Middleton, finally dispatched penalty, keeps her calm, keeps her nerve, and you think that's going to head into half time. The tails up. Confidently expecting to be able to navigate the second half, but just before half time, we had this moment. Emily Derry sweeping the ball in, slightly mishit, but what a composed finish that is from Rebecca Teal. You just see the mishit with the right foot, but there she is, quickly to react. Rebecca Teal, what a lovely finish. And her influence on this game wasn't to end there. She was instrumental in everything good in the second half alongside Amelie Derry. What a fantastic finish that was from Walder to make it 3-3. Watching the build-up play. Another one, Amy Bouyer had a couple of shots, decided on that occasion to use the finest and deftest of touch to pick her out on the far post. And Brolty Walder, well, superb to bring it level. We thought we were heading to penalties. And then in the final minute of the game, just that hesitation in defence cost them so dearly. It's painful for all those from Durham Johnston to watch the moment of magic from that girl, Rebecca Teal, to wheel away in absolute delight. Join her teammates down there,
to lift this trophy. The Under 14 Girls Schools Cup Final confirmation there. Blenheim High School 4, Durham Johnston 3. The trophy to be presented any second now.
Audience members, we are first going to give out to our PlayStation 4 winner. He's going to win a PlayStation 4 today here at the Crossbar through the Crossbar Challenge. Where is Alex? Where is he? Amazing stuff. Give it up for him one more time. Good work, champ. I'd be looking to have got an orange when I was that age, and he's got two PS4s. So, moving on, I'd like to officially ask the officials to come up and give them a huge round of applause. They were officially fantastic here today. Great flagsmanship from these chaps. Oh, wonderful. And the man in yellow as well, very, very well deserved. Now, I would like to announce our woman of the match, El Capitan for Blenheim, is Emily Curry! You are one PlayStation 4 Ritter as of right about now. Number 6, the captain, and it's no surprise that she played out on that field here today. You might have to go by another 10 controllers though before you invite the ladies now, but not a problem at all. Amazing stuff. Incredible. Well done, Emily. And now, please, everybody, whoever you come in to support, please put your hands together for the runners up. They played so incredibly well. And you should all be incredibly proud of yourselves, and they should all be incredibly proud of you, which I'm sure they are. Give it up for Durham Johnston. Goal!
Collecting our awards from the chairman of the EXFA is your goalkeeper, number one, Erin Jacques.
Keep it friendly and respectful for everyone, please, guys. It takes a lot to get to this kind of stadium and play a game of football like this. There should be nothing but respect for every single person, because they deserve every last bit of it. They played so incredibly well. And look at where ladies football has taken them. They are playing here in a stadium where so many top and world level footballers have played before them. Durham Johnston School. What an exciting game. One last time, that is Durham Johnston School. And now, your winners and champions, Blenheim High!
And collecting their medals and trophy, goalkeeper playing in one, Lara Sparrow. Player two, Ocean Garmin. In three, Freya Chabot. In four, Hannah Pinchbeck. In five, Leah Sheeran. In seven, Casey Bray. In eight, Amy Bouge. In nine, Becky Mayersbeth. Player 10, Bronte Walder. Player 11, Rebecca Teal. 12, Rhea Hatton. And your captain, Emily Darcy.
And that's Derry. And of course, team management, Mr. Millard and Mr. Morgan. I hope you've all got your camera phones at the ready. Send them to picture mode, because in just a couple of seconds, it's going to be officially time to celebrate as we get the board out of the way and the ladies lift their trophy. Your 2018 PlayStation 4 Cup champion!
With me here is Stuart Millard, the team manager for the winning team at Blenheim. Stuart, that was quite a roller coaster of a match today.
Oh, we always had faith. We knew that if we kept playing our football that we'd get a goal, but we left that one a little bit too late for my liking.
It was fair to say the attacking units were on top on both sides. 4-3, real roller coaster game, but you know, a really good performance for the girls to sort of, you know, really get down to it and grind the result out.
Yeah, they've won in different ways all season. They always stick to the ethos of playing football, and that's what won us the game in the end. I think we just applied pressure, and eventually we scored.
Yeah, you've had a good support here. I can see a lot of parents there. Hello, parents. And the girls still taking the plaudits. It looks like you're going to stay dry as well, which is unusual. But well done. Where do you go with this team now from here on?
Well, we're going to keep trying to get to places like this and winning trophies like this. There's no stopping now. They're going to push on. They're going to get better and better. And we'll hopefully be in the Champions League in a couple of years.
Yeah, well, absolutely. Well, you know, there's hundreds of teams entered this. This is not the old days of girls football where you only got 8 or 10 teams. Hundreds and hundreds of teams have entered and your team have come out on top. It's going to be a nice little journey home today for you.
I'm looking forward to the coach ride home and the celebrations afterwards. And maybe we can have a bank holiday at school tomorrow. We'll ask Mr. Bodell, the head teacher.
Maybe they'll cancel exams or something like that. Look, Stuart, thank you very much for your time. Congratulations. Well done, Blenheim.
Thank you.